to see the Bronze Bomber himself. It is great to see a man. Oh, man, he looks amazing. Deontay Wilder, the Bronze Bomber, back in action. Before we get to Luis Ortiz and Andy Ruiz, the presale went on today in Brooklyn at Barclays Center. A lot of people are talking about they're welcoming you back in Brooklyn. That's a venue you've had some successful moments. Your first fight against Luis Ortiz, what a battle that was. Your knockout against Bermain Stiverne. Arthur Spica still hasn't woken up since the rocket that you landed on him. But now that you're back, what does it feel like? I've seen photos, Instagrams, you're in the gym. You're looking in great shape, but how's the Bronze Bomber feeling?
Man, I'm feeling amazing. I'm feeling amazing, Ray. It's good to see you, man. You always bring great energy. And when I see you, I can't do nothing but smile because, you know, when you're letting your little light of mine shine, you know, everybody around like started to come on and shine as well. So, you know, but I've been doing amazing, you know. It's been good to just get away a little bit, check on the kids and watch them grow a little bit more. You know, I always have my children, but it's something special when you can just like put away everything on the shelf for a minute, you know what I mean? And drink you some watermelon juice with some lime in it. It's refreshing, you know what I mean? If you drink too much, it may give you the run, so you gotta be careful on how many you get. But, you know, it's just been refreshing. I've been happy. I always tell people, you know, for me, I don't dwell on money or materialistic things. It's all about my happiness and my peace, because I can be a man that have everything in the world but and can be miserable because I don't have my happiness and my peace. See, that right there you can't buy. And when you have your happiness and your peace, no matter what goes right or go wrong, you good either way it go. It's just life, then you just deal with it. So, but to make a long story short, man, I've been blessed, bro. The family's been blessed, and a lot has gone on in my life, you know, in a positive way. And here I am now, you know, I'm back for the second reign, more so to motivate, to inspire, you know. It was one point in time I was questioning myself, why would you come back? Coming back for what? You know what I mean? Because I did it for my daughter that was born with spina bifida to get in there, and now I have. Now I have added tremendously to the addition to the family. I have 8 children now. So, you know, it's been a blessing to raise them and to be able to have wills and set things in their future for them. Not only I think about their current right now, but I think about their future as well, that what kind of father they have in their life. And it's been amazing just to watch those guys grow, to see how intelligent they are, how much they comprehend and understand what goes on in the world and that is going on in the world. So I had a meeting with them, and I got all my kids together. I said, how you feel about daddy coming back? You know, all of them was for it, though. You know, it wasn't no surprise to me. You know, they love seeing their father in and out of the ring. They think I'm the best dad in the world, as any dad should be to their children, you know, that loves their children. You understand what I'm saying? Subliminal. That's a message. Come on, fathers. But it's amazing. But once I got my statue and I saw the people that came and came and celebrated with me, men and women, and a lot of men came and was very emotional and broke down to me and had their children and their sons to say, this is what a real king represents and look like, you know, especially from people coming all over the world, coming to see. It allowed me to understand that I got a little bit more to go. I can't quit now. I can't put it on the shelf now. This isn't not the end yet, because I have so many people that I motivate and inspire around the world, you know.
Well, I feel like you're just a natural born entertainer. From your ring walks that I've seen you throughout the course of your career, you love to fight. I mean, you did it to begin for your daughter, obviously, but now you have generational and 5 or 6 generational wealths that you've been able to accomplish, which you deserve. But I feel like you're a born entertainer and that you miss the sport of boxing. Is that fair to say?
You know, I'm definitely an entertainer, you know, and but I don't know if I missed the business, you know, at least back then. I was, like I said, if I missed it so, it wouldn't took this long. You know, I've accomplished so much. I've done so much. I've sacrificed my life for others' entertainment, and a lot of people don't understand what that means. They hear me when I say, but you can't relate or understand the meaning behind what that means. You know, it takes a lot for fighters, any fighters around the world, combat sport, it takes a lot, especially in this ring. It takes a lot for us to get up, go train, and get ourselves together weeks, months at a time to break our body down, then get in the ring, get hit in the head, which the head is not meant to be hit in the first place. You understand what I'm saying? So imagine, they always talk about, yeah, it's a lot of mental health. It's a lot of PTSD, a lot of stuff that fighters deal with. But, you know, a lot of them want to keep that toughness about themselves, don't want to let people know or see certain things wrong with them, because we're warriors at the end of the day.
It's okay to have vulnerabilities.
You know, it's okay. And that's why I come in. I show men that it's okay to do certain things and be cool to doing it, no matter what people may feel or think about you, because we only have one life in this lifetime, you know, and we got to make the best of it. That's why I tell people to be great at what you do, because the inevitable is chasing us every day. And I want to be a person that when it's time for me, when the inevitable come for me, the world will say, that's a great man we lost. He left it all in the ring, and he did a great duty on the outside of the ring as well. Because I tell everyone, we all have greatness in us, for greatness is only determined by service. And it don't cost much to put a little bit of time of greatness in your life. You ain't got to be great at every little thing that you do, just a little bit of it.
Well, you're matching up against Robert Hellenius in about 2 months on Fox Sports PBC pay-per-view October 15th at Barclays Center. He's not an easy opponent.
At all.
And you could have easily come back and taken an opponent of lesser opposition. But instead, people are saying, wow, Hellenius, this is a very tough guy known as the Nordic Nightmare. Defeated Adam Kovnatsky twice. Why Hellenius in your comeback fight?
I mean, why not? You know, in my career and even in my second reign career, you know, I always want to fight nothing but the best. I deserve it for myself, and I deserve it for the fans. And the fans deserve it from me for me to fight the best and nothing less. You know what I mean? There's so much I can say about that as far as people fighting the best and making it. But it's just me. That's just my heart. That's just where I want to be. And I don't want to stop. I just want to continue to keep moving forward. The Bronze Bomber is back. You know, hope I can be a light, an inspiration, a motivation to so many, not only people on the outside, but the fighters on the inside, you know. And with coming back with Robert, you know, you got to understand, this has been my sparring partner for a few years, so we know each other well.
I think that makes for a more exciting fight. I think you guys are going to let the leather fly even more so.
Yes, exactly. And that's why I start laughing like I do. I mean, I truly respect Robert and his craft. He's a warrior just like me. He got a warrior heart just like me. See, the thing about it, Ray, many people think the mind controls everything. True enough, the mind is a terrible thing to waste, but the heart controls it all. The heart controls your mind, your body, and your soul. You know what I'm saying? Because you can have the mind to want to quit at times, but your heart just wouldn't let you do it. You know what I'm saying? Your heart overcome everything, you know?
So you mentioned the heart. So in the lead up to Luis Ortiz, Andy Ruiz, you're picking Luis Ortiz to knock out Andy Ruiz. So you shared the ring with Luis Ortiz, not on one occasion, on two occasions. Yeah. So I'm going to ask you, are you picking with your heart, or are you picking with your mind, or is it a combination of both?
I'm going with my heart. Luis Ortiz is another one that has heart. Why you think so many fighters wouldn't give him the chance? And you got a guy like me looking up on them. I'm like, guys, come on. This is what we in here for. This is a gladiator sport. Come on. Why don't give another man an opportunity to make some money that's trying to do the same damn thing you're trying to do?
Well, isn't that been the story of your career throughout the course of your career? I mean, what you did with Luis Ortiz, what you did against Tyson Fury, given opportunities because you felt that they deserved the opportunity because you wanted the challenge. I think that's accurate, don't you?
Most definitely, you know, and it makes me feel so good as a human being knowing that I've changed lives in my profession, in my career, because no fighter really want to be in here long. We just want to make money and support our family and go home. You know what I mean? That's the reason we get in here. You don't see nobody with a silver spoon getting this sport unless they're doing exhibitions or something like that. Not the real jungle. Because if you don't have to do it, you ain't going to get in this ring. You might talk on the outside, but it's a different thing when you get up in the jungle.
So from a planning standpoint, you know, I know you're focused on October 15th, but have you thought about what could possibly be next? AJ and Usyk are going to fight on Saturday. You know, do you think an impressive performance goes ahead and puts you in line for that, depending on what happens with Tyson Fury? If he retires or not, we're hearing that he needs to let his intentions be known at the end of the month. Is that the fight you want next for the title? Or I know that you even mentioned, hey, Luis Ortiz and I might be able to do it again in a third time, depending on how he looks against Andy Ruiz. Where's the Bronze Bomber's mindset at?
I mean, my mind is unifying. Whatever route that takes me, the quickest route to take me is to unifying. That's where I'm going, you know. I'm not ducking and dodging anyone. I never have and never will. Everyone knows that. And you know, when you're fighting against me, everything depends on it. Everything. Because that's just how I think. I already know the business of boxing. It's not a sport to me. To call it a sport is a masking agent to what really it is. It's a business. And I handle the business accordingly, you know. And within the business, I love this business. Because it can make a poor man rich, but it also can make a rich man poor. So it's all about how you deal your cards, you know. And I love being able to motivate and inspire and change lives. And boxing have changed my life 3 or 4 times in my life, you know. And now I'm sitting back on the end of it, enjoying this ring while I want to motivate and help a lot of other fighters. I want to motivate and help a lot of other people on the outside of the ring. Because I only have until I'm 40.
And so that's you're going to 40 and that's it?
I'm done. I still want to continue my 3 fights a year.
Three fights a year?
I'm with it, man.
I love that.
Young.
But 3 fights a year?
I'm young.
I love that.
Come on. I'm young. So I feel great, you know. I mean, like I said, when you have your happiness and your peace, you're only building from there. It's never a downfall. You know what I mean? You're only just building from there. And to have so much love around you and stuff like that, it's refreshing. You know, even when people think you're down and sad and out because of whatever reasoning they have in their head. That's why I tell people I don't live for them. I live for myself. This is a nice jacket, by the way.
Oh, appreciate it.
Always looking fly.
I appreciate it. Likewise, Jeff. And the Bomb Squad back intact. I see Malik Scott's here in Las Vegas. The entire team is ready to rock and roll. Have you guys started training camp yet? Or, I mean, because I see you've been in the gym, but has training camp officially started is my question.
My pre-training camp has started. It's been started. I've done 253 rounds in 11 days, so... And then run Monday, Wednesday.
Wait, 253 in 11 days?
253 in 11 days. And
wow.
Run Monday, Wednesdays, and Friday. So I've been here in Vegas with Don House and Malik, JD's cuz here. You know, all my team and stuff. We've just been enjoying it, you know. And it's been a real treat. Been going to the USC Dana White Contender Series and watching those guys and looking at that beautiful, beautiful facility he have. He had an $8 million facility over there now that you see, and that Apex they got over there, man. It's been beautiful to be over there, refreshing, to get so much treatment over there and training and just the loving of the people, you know. And
Will you be in L.A. for Ruiz and Ortiz? You're going to be watching at home on pay-per-view. I know you're in training camp, but will you be at the fight? Have you not made a decision on that yet?
I haven't made it a decision yet, but we most likely may be in camp. You know, you can't take Robert Hellenius lightly. He's not one of those guys to look over. You know, many people may have their opinion of judgment inside while looking up on him inside of the ring and stuff like that. But when you have a man that got a heart of gold and a warrior mindset, a warrior's heart, it's unpredictable with what they can do. You can't look past a man like that because with that heart, he fears nothing, especially not man. You know what I'm saying? It's do or die. And that's what Robert has. He has a do or die mentality just like I. So please, this is not gonna be a light fight, and I am not taking it lightly. Again, understand, I've done 253 rounds in 11 days. It's really unheard of. you know.
Well, the one thing I know about the Bronze Bomber, when it comes to any fight you're in, it's always physical. Bam. It's always exciting. It's always aggressive. And don't blink.
Or bam, baby, good night.
Deontay, appreciate it. The Bronze Bomber, he looks in great shape as always. He's slicked out. He's wearing J's, being from Chicago. He's always got Michael Jordan on. I love it. Deontay Wilder.
Bomb Squad!
He's back October 15th. We'll come back with more here in Las Vegas. Luis King Kong Ortiz, good to see Showtime Sean Porter in the house, Fox Sports analyst as well. Luis King Kong Ortiz matching up against Andy Ruiz live on Fox Sports PBC pay-per-view. Do not miss it. A special Labor Day edition, Labor Day weekend edition of Fox Sports PBC pay-per-view. In the house, we have Deontay Wilder, spoke with the Bronze Bomber. Also, Michelle Rivera, lightweight sensation as well. He is in the gym. We see Malik Scott, who's been in the corner of Deontay Wilder. But right now you're watching Luis King Kong Ortiz workout. He is led by his esteemed trainer, Herman Caicedo, as they inch closer to Sunday, September 4th, on Fox Sports PBC pay-per-view. It'll be Luis Ortiz and Andy Ruiz colliding live from Crypto.com Arena, formerly known as the Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles, 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific Time. But the action gets going 2 hours prior, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific Time on FS1, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific Time on Fox, and then subsequently the pay-per-view at 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific Time. Back to the Luis Ortiz workout. Fox Sports PBC pay-per-view, Andy Ruiz, Luis Ortiz, back to Luis Ortiz workout. Thank you.
What'd you say?